Live from Dodd Stadium here in Norwich, Connecticut, we welcome you to PAC Network's production of the NEC 2014 Baseball Tournament. In game number one, we will see the Wagner Seahawks taking on the Bryant Bulldogs. And Salucci, the nine-hitter, finds himself in demand as an RBI guy. Throw down to first, and had we had a better pick at first base, you have an out. Instead, a run is going to come in and score. Poor infield defense there by Wagner as they create a situation that wasn't necessarily there. And Bryant scratches home its first run with a number nine hitter at the plate. So big chance for Bryant now. First pitch on the ground to shortstop, and Wagner losing out on a chance to maybe escape as the ball's booted at deep short by Maselli. Would have been very difficult to get to as the ball was deep in the hole, but another opportunity to collect an out goes by the board. Second error of the inning, second run of the inning, and it's now a 2-0 Bryant advantage. So turned over a pair of double plays today. This one will not be the third. Hit out into center field where it lands for an RBI single. Zach Yesko puts Wagner on the board, and it's a 2-1 game in the top of the sixth.
That's true.
2-1 pitch is hit out into center field. Not deep. This probably not deep enough. They will test Anderson. His throw is cut off. Why? In safely to score the tying run is Jason Gordon. There was no need for that throw to be cut off. If it bounces, chances are Gordon's out by 3 feet. Instead, it's a tie game on the sacrifice fly by Trey Nicosia. Like that or why? 2-0 pitch grounded down to shortstop. Glove there, another snow cone, but the only play is to first. The throw is late.
Oh, wow.
And a run comes in and scores. Everything going Bryant's way here. They regain the lead 3-2. Come back to regain the lead. 2-2 pitch hit on the ground. That's going to get through into left field for a base hit. One run is in, the ball right in front of third base, so they will hold the second run in Fabio, but Gavitt in to score, and Bryant, who had a two-run lead for most of the game, has one again in the bottom of the seventh, 4-2. 3-1 lifted. They were playing him to pull. This is to the opposite field. This is a hole in the defense, but the ball hangs up forever, and that allows Nicosia to compensate. However, it's more than deep enough for a sacrifice fly. In from third is Fabio, and Bryant now has its largest lead at 5-2 on the RBI sacrifice fly off the bat of Jordan Mountford. Now trying to finish up what would be his eighth in a complete game effort. The 1-2 hit high to center field, not deep, should be playable for Carl Anderson, and he will tuck it away for out number three for the out that retires the side and ends game one. For the second time in as many years, the Bryant Bulldogs, a debutante program here in Division I, are going to win 40 games.
With our Snyders of Hanover player of the game, Kevin McAvoy, and Bryant head coach Steve Owens as well. Probably one of the more unique complete games that you've ever had. Kind of a range of emotions. Talk about what you went through today.
Really the whole time, just trusting the defense was a big thing. They timed up some fastballs. They're pretty good hitters. But trusting the defense was big, and our defense played well.
That sixth inning, they end up getting those two runs, but your guys are able to battle back, get some runs for you. And then in the eighth, when you think maybe that you might go out, it might be time to pull you, coach ends up sticking with you. What were you feeling around that point? It seemed like after you got those first two outs that maybe you thought you might get that third one maybe a little easier than you did.
Well, coach, he knows what he's doing. And he trusts me to finish the game. That's what he told me before the game. He wanted me out there all day. And I'm just glad I could get through that.
You get to see the pen.
Yeah, it helps a lot. They're happy about that.
Go enjoy it. Congrats.
Thank you very much.
Kevin McAvoy, our Snyders of Hanover player of the game. Now bring in Steve Owens, the head coach. Talk about what you saw just from your starter there. Different complete game than maybe what he's accustomed to seeing.
Well, these are tournament games. They're hard. Everybody knows everybody, and Wagner's playing really well. They're playing well at the end of the year, and Jimmy's down and playing really well, and their kid pitched very well, too. The wind's blowing in. The ball's not going anywhere. It's really hard to hit an extra base hit. Kevin, I told him, I said, hey, we want you out there all day. And, work, keep working. If things get tough, just stick it out. And that's what he's done. He's really matured as a pitcher. He's always been a really good arm, and now he's a complete pitcher. And we played, he complimented his defense. We played poor defense today. We played really poor defense. We're lucky that we had such a good pitcher on the mound. You know, we did not take care of the baseball well at all. I thought our at-bats were okay. I think we struck a lot of good balls that just hung up and got caught. And then the very few scoring opportunities that we did have, we really took advantage of. And so, you know, I think it's a grinded out, good win for our guys to, you know, get ourselves into this tournament. And now we've got a really good pitcher going out there tomorrow and, you know, get after it then.
Well, you get off on the right foot. Go enjoy it for at least a little bit.
A little bit. Yeah, a little dinner, and then we'll start thinking about tomorrow.
That's Bryant head coach Steve Owens.